Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. And right here, I actually wanted to show off what would happen if you would decide to stop playing your game and play it again, and you would end up in the Jinjo Village. So that's a pretty convenient place, and got a nice little tune right here. I don't mind coming back to this place every now and then. And since we activated the other silo in Wooded Hollow, it makes fast traveling to wherever you were fairly easy. So let's get back to the Wooded Hollow and enter the first world of the game. And before we do so, I actually wanted to show off one more thing. I'm not going to show off this. I've prolonged going to the first world long enough. I don't want to clutter it with going there. We'll go there maybe after the first world. Just know it's a place of importance that involves stop and swap once again. And hey, we found a Jinjo. Yippee, you saved me. I'm off for home now. And I always thought that, like, this was how the Jinjo would fly back to its home. I don't know. But basically, each of these Jinjo homes obviously represents one color of the Jinjos, so by saving this little pink one, there you go, purple Jinjo, sorry. Thanks for rescuing me, I live in this house with the rest of my similar colored family. So basically there's 8 of those purple Jinjos. Rescue us all and we'll give you a family heirloom. And that family heirloom would be, my guess would be something that starts with a J, ends in an Iggy. Might be a Jiggy, I don't know, but yes, now that we rescued that Jinjo, let's make our way into the first world of the game, shall we? It's been long enough, it's been 4 parts, might as well get some progress. Alright, so here we are, this is Mayahem Temple. This is a warp pad, find another one in this world and you'll be able to warp between them. New feature in this game, basically there's warp pads spread around the whole entire world that makes fast traveling much easier. That and the silo is just a godsend in this game, because it is a very open world, unlike the lair from the last one. And if we just jump in this pool right here, there's actually a Jinjo, so let's actually rescue him. I don't know how he's surviving down there, I guess Jinjos have gills, and that's a red one, okay. So we got 6 of those red ones, made 8 of those purple ones, so you may think that finding all the Jinjos may be hard, but there's about like 4 or 5 Jinjos in each world, so they add up pretty quickly. And right here, these guys track you. Once we learn a move, we can actually destroy them. So for now, we'll just pass them by. And as you've noticed, each eggs and all that stuff are bundled in groups of 5, and so are notes. So yes, each note represents 5 notes. Let's actually talk to this guy right here. He seems to be guarding something of importance. And, oh, okay, I'll show this off right here. I shouldn't have gotten it, though, in hindsight. Press X to stop your energy bar as close to the top as possible. So yes, it has an exclamation point. Yeah, stop it. Come on. Whoops. Okay, I think it's X he said. There we go, okay. So yeah, if you're like have 1 HP, this could be a very good thing to do. If you only have a full one, then that could be very risky because there's no gain like I just did right there. So let's talk to this kitty cat. Stop right there. What do you want? We want to go in there as it sounds cool. It does. It sounds all festive-y. Of course it's cool. Everyone wants to see the Stony kickball games. Stand aside then, Bozo. We'll miss the action. Bozo? I'm Officer Uno Gopaz, and there ain't no tickets left. They sold out while they were planning Banjo-Kazooie. Playing Banjo-Kazooie, aw. We don't want to watch. We're here to kick butt and win. Nice try, but I'm afraid you can't. The games are only open to Stonies. Oh, go on, please. Nope. How about a bribe? How dare you? This is a respectable organization. Get lost, both of you. I just love all the dialogues between the characters in this game. I love all the fourth wall breaking as well. And what the hell? The stone creature right here. Let's see what he's got. Yeah, we speak English in this game. This game is so funny. But yeah, we can't talk to that guy just yet, as we saw. He was speaking some foreign language, or he was speaking demonically backwards. I don't know. But as we see, we got 40 notes already, so since the groups of 5, you can get notes pretty fast in this game. And let's see, what's this? Hey, get your sorry hide over here and press B! Alright, Sarge. Okay, I gotta really get a nice voice right here. Okay. Okay, got it.
Drill Sergeant Jam Jar's reporting for duty, sir!
Banjo, get a load of this bozo. He looks like Bottles in uniform.
Of course I look like Bottles, you punk. He's my brother. Keeps the geek keeping anyway.
Not too good. Recently deceased at the hands of Grunty the Witch.
Sorry to hear that. Flea ball, did he go out fighting? playing cards, actually. Typical. You see, so you want to be learning some top moves, some of my special moves to get even with the witch, huh? Not really, Bottles taught us loads in the last game. Ha, he only knew novice moves. You'll get nowhere without my advanced techniques. Sounds good to us, Jam Jars. Why not teach us a few now? Not that easy, Punk. You've got to prove yourselves first by collecting me a few notes. Come back if you can. Oh, my guy's eyes. Hey, wait a minute. I believe we have enough notes, though. I see you've got enough notes for my first lesson. Listen and learn, you punks. Alright, so this is the egg aim. What you need is an aiming sight, hit the target, and you with all your might. First person view by pressing Y, hit LT or RT to fire with accuracy. That'll be all. Dismissed! Ah, okay. Yeah, so basically, if you collect a number of notes, that's what notes represent in this game, not only just getting 100 for the completion of the world, you can learn new moves by going to Jam Jars. So we learned the egg aim, so let's hit Y right there. And we aim right here at the yellow spot. Oh, guy's staring at me. Fire! And that temporarily disables him, so that's actually pretty cool right there. You don't have to actually zoom in and do this normally. But a thing with him is sometimes he does a certain funny thing when he dismisses you. And I won't be spoiling it, but I really bank on it every single time. That's like the only thing I look forward to, besides getting the new moves from Jam Jars. And for now, I'll avoid that a little temple thing over here. But we got Mumbo's house. Hey, he's actually in this game. He said he was going to help us after all. You found another warp head. Okay, basically now we can warp between these two. We couldn't warp between one, because that's just silly. So let's just actually go up here for a second, get some more notes. Yeah, you can pretty much collect all the notes in the first, like, minute of the world, which is pretty funny. So let's see. So basically, there's only 50 they have to collect. Oh god, I fell. Actually, oh, there it is, okay. I thought it was on the top, but there's something else on the top. Oh, that's a, what is that, stiletto? A treble clutch, okay, stiletto. What the hell's that? So we got 100 notes right here. There's a move we can learn over there. But I kind of want to make that coincide of going into this place, because to go in this place, you have to know that move, and I don't want to just learn it now, and then, I don't know. I want to keep it all nice and together. Or, I don't know, do I want to learn it now? I don't know, but we have a note up here on the Sanger. Cool, first Jiggy of the game, actually, that we got, so. Not a gift, but the one we actually earned. You know what, I might as well. We'll be going in this probably the last part, but I want to learn this anyway. Yeah, that's probably the best. The best course of action. I'll probably forget doing this anyway, so might as well do it now. So you only need 30 notes, so let's learn this new move. The second one in this world. The Breagle Blaster. Here's a move that's a load of fun. Now use Kazooie as a handheld gun. LTRT fires eggs both high and low. Target is an example, and you go. And he heals you, basically. Fighting it tough, huh? Looks like you need some rations. Like Bottles, he heals us. Cool. That'll be all. Dismissed. Ah. Man. Soon. I think it takes a couple times for that to kick in. But it will happen. It will happen. So basically, yeah, that move we'll be learning. Or not learning, but we'll be using later when we enter that little temple. But I'd like to save that for now. Oh god, it's an albino Jinjo! One of one! Wow, okay, we already rescued this guy's family. Some family. He must be so lonely all alone. This poor Jinjo. Aw, oh, poor little guy. Of course it's the white. Okay, I'm not gonna... I know it's really easy to make race jokes with these Jinjos, but I'm really not going to go there. Phew, I am grateful for your help. I thought I'd never find my way home. Take this Jiggy for your trouble. Oh, that's so depressing, too. Like, he gives us his Jiggy, and now we're going to, like, see the end of his race, because there's going to be no more white Jinjos. He's in... I guess, I don't know, do Jinjos, like, I was gonna say if like they mate like a white one goes with a black one, does it create a gray one, like a rainbow kind of thing? I don't know. Look at the state of poor Bovanus Field. This plague of filthy flies is scoffing my crops. Oh dear, how can we help? Get rid of the pesky flies, of course. Say your prayers, flies. Oh man, these flies have given this cow the vapors. Okay, I brought up that expression yesterday when it's like so hot and my parents didn't get it, so I sounded like such a fool. But I love that expression. This heat's giving me the vapors. I like talking like a southern gentleman. I say. But yeah, let's take out these pesky flies. We don't have a bug zapper, but that new aiming thing we learned was actually pretty useful. And my practice file actually got these all in one shot. Four shots, four kills, and I'm having a rough time here. Alright, we got him. Amazing! I could hardly believe it. You wheatless sorted those flies out. Enough with the puns. Hey, enough of the crop jokes, lady. I believe you owe us a jiggy. Oh, I guess I do.
Well, thanks there, Clarabelle, and, stop jumping there. Don't have a cow, but I guess you're excited. And there we go, the next Jiggy. Jiggy number 3 in this world? Well, I guess, I don't know, technically 2nd because the Jinjo one and the Jingling one and whatnot. And there's actually Empty Honeycomb up here. We cannot reach it because we don't know that move. I think it's the last move you can learn here. So they throw out 3 new moves you can learn in this world out there fast. So pretty cool, I guess. And so yes, we're going to actually go and visit Mumbo. And because basically you want to do Mumbo's thing first in this world just to get it out of the way. Basically, Mumbo is in all the worlds and he can help you by doing various things. But we will see what is different about him in this game. And this is actually a different thing as well. You've caught a Globo. They're supposed to have magical powers. I wonder what we do with it. I don't know, let's see. Mumbo, wow, sweet digs, man. You built an upstairs between 2 years? You must have gotten a lot of money from the last game. How much were we paying you? Thought your service was free. Ah, Baron Bird here at last. Mumbo best shaman in game, so built new skull. Mumbo also want to help, but must find me magic creature. We found a Globo. We've got a Globo. Must give magic creature to Mumbo if want help. Want Mumbo's help? Yes, we do. Sure, we need all the help we can get. Throw it in Mumbo's bag. And we throw the Globo in Mumbo's sack, and he comes off his throne and gets his stick, and there we go. Ah, Mumbo get to be hero at last. Press B to see mighty shaman Zapstick. Return me to chair when you want to see Baron Bird again. Yes, in Banjo-Tooie, you get to play as Mumbo. See that? That's just like one of the benefits of this game as opposed to the last game. Just making a little list right here and just tallying it up. I don't know, right now I'm leaning toward Banjo-Tooie. I don't know, I'm feeling it. But let's see, let's get this guy out of here. Oh, he's afraid of it. Zap, come on. Ah, oh my god. So yeah, basically Mumbo's attack is pretty weak, but it does the job and electrocutes enemies to death. Gruesome, I know, but a necessary sacrifice. But yeah, so Mumbo, he basically has that and he has this little jump right here. Other than that, he has no moves that Banjo-Kazooie knows, so what you have to do is basically scatter throughout the worlds are Mumbo pads, and if you go on the Mumbo pad, press B to see mighty Mumbo magic. Here we go. Mumbo, take it away. Hope this works. Alright, so we're summoning a golden Goliath. Basically, Mumbo does this little jig right here to summon things, and he does not transform you into creatures, unlike the last game. He actually uses magic to do things like this. Alright, so we got this big little bear, golden kind of thing, checking out his potty for the first time. Mumbo magic make golden Goliath rise. Magic only lasts short time. To control me again, return statue to its base and press B. Okay, so basically, we only have a certain amount of time to control this thing, and we have to do this fast. There's a number of things we can actually do with this golden Goliath, so let's get on to it. You want to hit this boulder right here, it reveals a fly pad. Very useful, we can actually destroy these things as well. If you want, but not really necessary. But yeah, that fly pad is very important in this world. I'll be using that a lot. It's very convenient to actually bypass getting the last move we can get. That is actually right there. I don't know why I was pointing to it. But yeah, as you can tell, it's necessary to get that Jinjo, and it's evolving some sort of grip grab kind of thing. Ah, what the hell? I'll just walk into you. But yeah, it's a Jiggy right there you can get. I just want to make this fast, though. Alright, so basically we have to make our way to crush one other gate, then we're done with the Golden Goliath, but you needed the Golden Goliath to get that Jiggy right there, so there, I'm gonna say right now, those little stone things, the ones we couldn't understand, actually give you hints throughout the world, but since we don't understand them yet, we don't really know what they're saying, but basically the one that was right there would say, oh, you need a certain statue to get that Jiggy, and whatnot. Do I have time to do this? Oh my god, this is gonna be close, this is gonna be really close. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Happy Goliath! Okay, we did it. All right. We did it in the allocated time. Oh, I was going to destroy that thing. Mumbo magic run out. Aw, I just hate that when the Goliath runs out of power, he just does that little sad thing. But I think we're done with the Goliath. That's all we had to do. We pretty much opened all the things, so we're done with Mumbo. So, I think when we return Mumbo, we're going to call it a part because I don't want to make these parts too long because recording with the Elgato, I upload straight from it, and if the file's too big, sometimes YouTube doesn't use it, and I have to do it in Stony Vegas, and it takes a little more time. So, I think that this is the perfect time to end it. We pretty much did all of the rudimentary things, as you would say, in Mayahem Temple. And the next part will be getting to the meat of it and getting way more Jiggies and way more Jinjos and way more of everything and learning the last move we can learn. So let's return Mumbo to the throne. And I'm sorry, Mumbo, but you did a good job here. You actually, you're very useful in this game. You were in the last game, but in this one, you actually get to go out and see the world. All right, so we're back here, and yes, so I'll end it here. So thank you guys for watching. Be sure to leave a like, leave a comment. How am I doing? Been enjoying the series and whatnot, and share it with your friends. Leave a favorite as well, or do a favor. You can't leave a favorite unless it's mine. Okay. All right, so I'll see you later, guys, and until next time on Let's Play Banjo-Tooie, we'll be exploring more of Mayahem Temple. So see you later, guys, and until next time.